A stone is allowed to fall from the top of a tower 100 meter high, and at the same time, another stone is projected vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity of 25 meter second inverse. Calculate when and where these two stones will meet. So, is for example, see here we are having building 100 meter high, right? Now, same time, one stone drop downward direction, and another stone we throw upward direction with velocity. So throwing velocity that we have 25 meter second inverse, right? And here initial velocity is zero, right? So that throwing object, right, its final will be zero because of that maximum height. And v of that dropping stone we don't have. Now I am putting one equation for dropping stone, that is s, right? So s is equal to ut plus half gt square. So for first dropping one we don't have u, that's why zero. Only we have half here g, we are dropping it downward direction, that's why g we have to take it as positive, so g into t square, right? So we can write 5t square, right? Now for throwing stone, which is upward direction, so s dash is equal to throwing, so again same formula, but here 25, which is u t plus half here minus g into t square, because wherever they meet they took same time, so t is constant here, right? So s dash becomes 25 t minus gt square by 2, right? Now what happened, whatever this dropping stone cover and that throwing stone cover, when they meet at the same time, they cover exactly same distance, which is s plus s dash will be 100 meter, that is the exactly height of that tower, right? So 100 meter is the total distance. So put this s into here, so 5t square will be there plus s dash. What is s dash? 25t minus gt square by 2. So gt means 5t square, right? So here that is correct for 5t square, that is good. So 5t square is equal to 100 meter, right? Now 5t square gets cancelled out, so we are left with 25t is equal to 100 meter. So t will be 4 seconds. So here t is that time when they are at the same place, they will meet in 4 seconds, right? That is our first answer. And now question is where they will meet. So we can put this t in the first, s is equal to 5t square, right? So s is equal to 5 into t square is 16. So s is 16, 80 meter, right? So earlier that s is, this s is about to leave that stone, so dropping that stone, so from height 80 meter, but from the bottom 100 minus 80, so 100 minus 80 is equal to 20 meter. So our final answer I am writing here, 20 meter is the final answer, and that is the place when they meet from the bottom, but from the top it will be 80 meter, right? So first is 4 seconds, that is our first answer, and the second answer, that is 20 meter when they meet.